In this video, we will create an animated gradient background by using any kind of colorful image, which is super easy to create inside of Adobe After Effects. Hey guys, this is Vikas from Skyline Motions, and without any further ado, let's jump into the After Effects and get started. Alright, so here we are in Adobe After Effects, and if you are watching this video first time on this channel, please hit the subscribe button, turn on the bell notification for more interesting videos, and also hit the like button for this video. Now let's start by creating a new composition. So click on this new composition button, or you can just go over here and take a new composition, and this is gonna be the main composition, so let's call it main. Set the size of this composition, maybe 1920 by 1080, which is the 1080 resolution. You can select 4K resolution as well. Now we have to select a frame rate. So in this case, I'm using 60 frames per second, but you can select 24 frames per second or 30 frames per second according to you. Now we have to set the duration of this composition, maybe 5 seconds long, but you can increase or decrease the duration according to you. Select the background color black, hit OK. Now we have to import any colorful image to create this type of gradient background. So just go to the project window, right click on that, go to import file and select any image. So in this case, I'm using this image that I have downloaded from unsplash.com, and I will give you a link in the description for these type of images. Now you can select your image and click on import. Now we have to create a media composition by using this image. So it's very simple. Just drag and drop the image on this little composition icon over here, and we will get the new composition. You can rename the composition. So right click on the new composition, click on rename, call it media. So this is the media composition where we can drag and drop our image or video file. Now we have to create a duplicate of the media composition. So hit Ctrl D to duplicate. Right click on the second media composition, click on rename. Let's call it image. Hit enter. Now just double click on this image and open it up. Select the image inside of it and delete it. Now we have to drag and drop the media composition inside of the image composition. And then we have to apply some effect on it. So just go to effect and preset and search for directional blur. So this is the directional blur effect. Let's drag and drop on the image. And here we have the blur length value. So let's increase the blur length value and set the value maybe 300, direction maybe 50 degree. Now we have to apply one more effect, which is the brightness and contrast. So let's search for brightness and contrast. So this is the brightness and contrast. Drag and drop the effect on the image, and here we have the contrast. Let's increase the contrast value and set the value maybe 60 and make it like this. After that, you can close the image composition and the media composition and go to the main composition, and then we have to go on the project window, and this is the image composition. Let's drag and drop into this main composition just like that. Hit S on the keyboard to open this scale property. Let's scale it down a bit and set the value maybe 18%. Basically, we have to fit the image according to this composition. And then we have to apply one more effect, which is the TWIRL. So just go to the effect and preset and search for TWIRL effect. So this is the TWIRL effect. Let's drag and drop on the image composition just like that. And here we have the angle. So I'm gonna set the angle value maybe 400 degree. Now we need only circular shape. So what we have to do, we have to create a matte layer. So select the ellipse tool from here, click on fill, set it to solid color, click on stroke, set it to none, hit OK, and we have to create circular shape. So hold left mouse button, hold Ctrl Shift and create a circular shape just like that. Now you can close the shape layer, select the shape layer, right click on that, click on rename, call it matte. Select the matte layer and we have to align it to the center. So select the move tool, go to align, click on the align horizontally, click on the align vertically. Basically, we have to set the shape layer in the center. After that, we have the track matte option. If you don't have the track matte option, you can click on the toggle switches. And now we have to change the bottom layer track matte to alpha matte. And we will get something like this. Now we have to create an animation. So select the image, hit R on the keyboard to open the rotation parameter, and here we have to animate the rotation. So hold Alt on the keyboard and click on the stopwatch button to open the expression box, and we have to type an expression over here. So I'm gonna type time multiply by 20 degree, and we will get the continuous animation just like that. After that, you can close the image layer. And now select both the layers, right click on that, click on pre-compose, and this is going to be the animation layer. So I'm going to call it animation. Check this option, move all attributes into the new composition, hit OK. And after that, we have to apply one more effect, which is the optics composition. So just go to effect and preset and search for optics. So this is the optics composition. Let's apply the effect on the animation layer just like that. And here we have the reverse lens distortion. So check this option, reverse lens distortion. Let's increase the field of view. So I'm going to set the value maybe 150 at very beginning of this animation. Now let's animate the field of view parameter. So click on this stopwatch button to create a keyframe at very beginning of this animation. Just go to the end of this animation and set the value maybe 160. Now we will get something like this. After that, let's apply one more effect, which is the glow effect. So just go to effect and preset and search for glow. So this is the glow effect. Let's drag and drop on the animation composition, and here we have the glow radius. Let's increase the glow radius value and set the value maybe 500. And finally, we will get something like this. Now let me show you the best feature of this type of animated gradient background. You only have to go on the optics composition effect. You can close the glow effect, and here we have the view center. So this is the view center point. You can move the point from here and create variation inside of this animated gradient background, as you can see. So you can place the view center point anywhere in the frame and create unique design according to you. Just like that. You can use this background on any text, logo, whatever you want. So let's add a text over here. So it's very simple. Select the text tool, go to character. If you don't have the character, then go to window and check this option, character, and let's select a font style. So in this case, I'm using the Arkitech font style. Set it to the light, set the size maybe 90 pixel, character spacing 250. Click over here and type anything, whatever you want. Just like that. Hit Ctrl A to highlight all, and let's align it to the center. Now this is the animated gradient background. Let me show you how you can change the gradient style. It's very simple. Just go to your project window, open the media composition, and you have to replace the image. So let's import any different image. I'm going to use this image. Click on import, drag the new image inside of the media composition just like that. And you can delete the previous one, but let's keep it. Select the new image, hit S to open the scale property. Let's increase the scale value and set it like this. After that, just go to your main composition, and here we will get the all new gradient background, which is absolutely perfect. Alright, so just go to very first frame of this animation, go to full screen, and let's have a look. Alright, so it's looking awesome, and that's all for this tutorial. I hope you guys like it. If you like it, then hit the subscribe button, turn on the bell notification for more interesting videos, and also hit the like button for this video. My name is Vikash, and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye bye.